We think of science as this isolated activity, but it actually requires this enormous infrastructure. Mark I really represents the moment where Harvard's relationship with how science is going to happen changes. The Mark I was an electromechanical calculator. It's a tool for doing mathematics in a new automated way. This is a mammoth machine. This is 5 tons, and it's very mechanical. This is very much a World War II machine. You have IBM making this in the 1930s. It arrives to Harvard in 1944. It's both civilian students at Harvard and members of the military, so people like Lieutenant Grace Hopper, who are actually doing the work. And so this World War II notion that really guides science at Harvard, that science can and actually must be in the public interest. So it's at this moment where you see this new partnership working towards this big science that becomes the engine of American innovation. The Mark I just caught so much public attention and excitement. So Time magazine calls it this, you know, Sybil, an unfailing priestess, but now it's most famous for bugging and debugging and finding problems and figuring out how to improve it. The lesson here is the thing we do with computers is figure out how to make them better, how to make them work for us. They don't arrive from IBM or on a conveyor belt as this fixed thing that is inherently unfailing. It's in fact this ongoing iterative process.